We want to graph a function that satisfies the following conditions. F prime of x is greater than 0 or positive on the open interval from 1 to 3. F prime of x is less than 0 or negative on the intervals from negative infinity to 1 and from 3 to infinity. And the function also has an x-intercept of 2 and a y-intercept of negative 1. Let's record the information about the first derivative on a number line. Notice how the derivative changes sign at positive 1 and positive 3, so we'll plot those two values on the number line. There's 1, and we'll call this 3. And because these intervals are open on 1 and 3, we'll make open points here and here. So on the interval from 1 to 3, the derivative is positive. And on the other two intervals, the derivative is less than 0 or negative. Remember, the first derivative tells us whether a function is increasing or decreasing. So on this interval on the left, the function must be decreasing or moving downward from left to right. And then from 1 to 3, the derivative is positive, so the function is increasing. And then from 3 to infinity, the derivative is negative, and therefore the function is decreasing again. This also tells us that we must have a relative minimum at x equals 1, because the function changes from decreasing to increasing, so we have a low point. And we also have a relative maximum at x equals 3, because the function changes from increasing to decreasing. Now let's go ahead and talk about the intercepts. We're given the x-intercept is positive 2 and the y-intercept is negative 1. So those are specific points on the function. So let's go ahead and plot those first. And then we'll see if we can satisfy the conditions listed here on the left. So the x-intercept is positive 2, this point here, and the y-intercept is negative 1. So the function has to pass through these two points, and to the left of negative 1, it must be moving downward from left to right or decreasing. And then at positive 1, the function starts to increase, passing through the x-intercept, and then at x equals 3, we have a relative maximum, and then it starts to decrease. Now let's see if we can plot a relative minimum at x equals 1 and a relative max at x equals 3. So to plot a low point at x equals 1, or relative minimum, we know it has to pass through these two points. So let's make this point here our relative minimum. Let's go ahead and label that. This represents the relative min. And then at x equals 3, we have a high point, or a relative maximum. So we know the function will pass through these three points. So let's make the relative maximum maybe this point here. Again, let's go ahead and label it. Now let's see if we can sketch our function. Again, to the left of negative 1, the function must be decreasing. So if we start here, the function must be going downhill from left to right. And then it reaches a low point at x equals 1 right here at our relative minimum. And then it starts to increase, passing through these two points. And then right at positive 3, the function starts to decrease again. So it reaches this high point, or relative max, and then starts to decrease. So here's a possible function that does satisfy the given conditions. The function is decreasing on this interval. We have a relative minimum, and then it increases. And then to the right of 3, it starts to decrease again. So these types of problems are a nice way to reinforce understanding the idea of what the first derivative tells us about a function. I hope you found this helpful.